Hi everyone, Adish here. Welcome to Adish Model Train. So today we're gonna discuss about current sensor for block occupancy detection. So in the previous discussions, we have seen like how we can create our own custom DIY CT sensor based block occupancy detection. But the problem with that is it always give us output in analog signals, and as we know that we have a limited number of pins in antennas, so we have a limited number, we can just plug limited number of analog current sensor to the antenna. So to overcome that, there's another option where we can have a proprietary CT sensor for block occupancy detection from NCE and from other brands. And there's a group which is known as MERG. So let me talk about that first. So if we see merg.org.uk, so this is a group with Model Electronics Railway Group. So these guys have their own custom proprietary CT sensor for block occupancy detection. So you can join this group. Here you can go and you can just join the group. We have for every country base, we have a different sort of fees, membership fees. And from USA, it's like £20 plus £5 for joining fees. But it's worth, because they have a good amount of, you know, knowledge repository where we can just explore a lot of things about electronics and circuitry to build a model layout. So I have bought already one of the kit from Merg, which is DTC2T. So they will send you a kit in nice packing. Here you can see they have sent me the kit in this packing and all. And once you open that, you will see it will be like this, and this contain resistors, instruction set, diodes, and current transformers and some wires. So once we so the only thing is that once they will send you everything, you have to solder it everything on the board and you have to build it. So once you solder it, it looks like something like this. So I'll zoom it for you. So this is it has two current transformers here. This is the input for line 1 and this is for the line 2. So we can for two blocks we can have track 1, track 2. For block 2, track 1, track 2. And here we can pass plus 5 volt, minus 5 volt, and X and Y for X block and Y block. You can get a digital signal, because this circuit, all these things, already some sort of thing we have already built in our DIY CT transformer circuit, but it doesn't have this which will convert analog to the digital signal. So for this, again we have to do a programming on Arduino. So I have already built a API. So you can go to github.com/adarshkumarsingh83 CT sensor - block - occupancy - detection library. So if you come into this, you can see this library has download link. This GitHub page has a download link for downloading the library. This will work with NCBD20, which is shown in the picture. This is a Merg circuitry which I have shown just now for X and Y. And here are the steps, what are the steps we have to follow. So first thing, we have to include the header file, number of sensors we want to use, create the object of CT sensor, initialize the CT sensor and pass in the number of counts, and then we have to initialize the serial monitor with the passing the supported baud rate. And then we have to mention that CCTV sensors on, we are just trying to, plug the CCTV sensors on which pin. So sensor 1 is plugged into pin 13, sensor 2 is pin 12, sensor 3 is 11, 4 is 10, 5 is 9, and so on we can do it. And in the loop method, what we can do, we can just call CCTV sensor dot is sensor active and passing the sequence number, sensor number. So it will tell us the state in Boolean whether sensor is active or not. And we can use display pin method also, which will tell us the state of the pins whatever for every sensor. So here I have done already how we can do the configuration. It's just a simple, you have to just take the output of the CCTV sensor, digital output of the CCTV sensor, and plug it to the Arduino. And here's a final example how we can do that. So let's see how we can just test it with the actual. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna download the library, install it in Arduino, and test it on the track. So let's download the library from the GitHub page. I have downloaded it on my desktop, Arduino. So I'm gonna open this Arduino, and then I'll go to a sketch, include library, add zip file, desktop, CT sensor block occupancy. I have included that, and then I'll go to examples, CT sensor block occupancy detection. I'll go to CT sensor block detection library. So here we have, it's the same code which I have explained earlier. So we have to include the library. Number of CT sensors we are using 2 here. And this is a X block LED and Y block LED on pin number 13 and 12. We have started the serial monitor. We have initialized the, we have created the CT sensor object here. Then we have initialized the serial monitor. Then we have initialized the CT sensor by passing the sensor count. Sensor 1 we are setting on pin number 7, sensor 2 we are setting on pin number 6, and for X block LED and Y block LED we have set the output pin mode. Then in the loop, we are just printing a next line, and we are calling CT sensor dot is sensor active 1. It will return us true or false, and based on that we are switching on the LED or switch off the LED. And same thing we are doing for sensor 2, where we are saying CT sensor is sensor active 2. If it is active, it will be high, otherwise it will be low. So this is a very simple application. So we'll see the configurations also. So here you can see, this is a sensor from, and this is a 5 volt plus and minus coming here, and we are passing it to sensor here, and from sensor X block and Y block pin is coming inside, and this is a X block LED and this is a Y block LED output, and pin number 13 and 12, and this will be pin number 6 and 7. And we are taking a common ground from Arduino, and we are passing to the LED, both the block LEDs here. And this is a simple resistor just to protect it from burning. So once train will come to the what's the best thing about this sensor is we are using, instead of analog pins, we are using digital pins here, pin number 6 and 7 for the reading input. So here what we'll do, we'll just install this. We will install this library to, so we'll compile it and we'll install it. And we'll monitor the state. So once locomotive will come to the block, automatically LED will turn into, it will start going. So here you can see LED is turned. And once it reaches here, it's a place where both the blocks are there. So here you can see it's in between both the blocks. So both the LEDs are on. Once it passes the block, so LED will go off. And the best thing is, once I'll shut down the locomotive also, then also it will detecting without flickering. And if I just go back into the same, yeah, you can see here like still LED is on for one of the block where locomotive is there. So that's how we can do the CT sensor based block occupancy detection, and this is a proprietary circuit from the Merck. We can use NCBD20 also, that is also work with this library. I have tested already, so hope this will help you to understand the implementation, how we can use the library as well as how we can do the configuration connection. All the details are already there in the GitHub page, you can follow that. That's it for this video. Thank you.